Hey everyone, this is part four of my sunset at the marina, and I'm starting to work on the sky area. So I have this covered with film, Frisket film right here, just this little area. In the part three video, you can see that I was using post notes to protect this area when I sprayed it. I chose to use the film, the clear Frisket right now, so I can kind of see by wiping off this, you can't really see the change and make sure I do have a dark enough value when I get into that area, because this is lighter than what's going to be there. Okay, and the area here, the sky is going to come down a little somewhere in this area, and then this will come back over it later. This is covered, the seagull's covered in Frisket also. All right, so I prepared that before, and now you can see on the reference picture, sorry about my arm there, that I have cut out islolation windows. It helps you get your, you can see the difference, your values and your exact colors by spraying test spray onto a white paper. I'll slide this under here and kind of have some tape there waiting for it just to hold it on there. Okay. All right. So you're supposed to aim it downward and you're supposed to have your lighting come in from behind. I'm trying to get close, but I don't really care if I get like perfect dead on target colors. They just have to be a decent, you know, match that will help me get the values. So we'll probably use two different values. I'll probably add sepia to the original color. The original color is, I think I've got orange. I've got burnt sienna, Createx paints. I've put white in it, yellow, and blue. Without putting the blue in there, even having the brown to gray down and darken the orange, I still noticed it was too, it was a bit saturated, bright. But if I run into any problems spraying the sky, I can always make a correction color and go back over. Blue skies are real, real fun and easy to paint. You don't have to worry about any color shifting, really, because blue is what usually colors shift over to. That's what happens. It's the warmer colors where you start to get into some trouble. But anyway, that's another story. I have the Micron airbrush. I'm going to load it up with the pre-mixed paint and try to continue a little bit here. Like I said, this is under Frisket, and if I didn't say that earlier in the video, yes, this is under Frisket too. So I'm on a different angle today. I'm working straight up, so I'm going to try to come in a little bit on the side here. It's much more comfortable for my neck, as I said in part three, and I also have to be concerned about freehand. The freehand area here, first I'll put it in lightly, no film. Now I'm going to test this. I might have to, yeah, okay, air on. Okay, so I'm just spraying right softly up to and onto a little bit my top of the boat here with the radar. And this is protected over here, obviously, so when I get to that area. But this area, I'll just do a little bit right in here. He's underneath the film, so he's going to be totally protected. I do want to cover the rest of the boat, the lower part. Right probably around there. OK. Okay, so now, again, no film, no frisket around that. Yes, here, because you can see in the reference picture, as soon as I free it up here, you can see the hard edge. And it is a hard edge, it's film. This is blurry. I'll bring it closer to the video here, to the camera. Okay, so I don't know if you can really see the fuzziness there on the video, but this is a harder edge anyway. There are some hard edges in there, but there's a lot of fuzzy edges too. So I was kind of just pay attention to the reference. Obviously, as I said earlier, the seagull is a very stenciled looking. It's kind of amazing because that was really the seagulls in the evening, you know, when I took the picture to look so much like a stencil, but that's what the silhouette came out of. I must have had the camera zooming in on him, and I got the beautiful blurry boat. It's not extremely blurry, but it is blurry, and blurry enough to make it very interesting and challenging. As you can see, even with the antennas and the wires, all of the different antennas or whatever they are that go on top of this thing, they're real. They're really faded. They're sprayed very lightly. So, having said that, I'm going to place this here, and I'm going to just try to work a little bit by the radar thing here. Okay, so let's come in from this angle. So you just want to get that distance airs on. I'm going to start. I got the old tip dry there. There we go. Yes, it is giving me the effect that I'm looking for. And I am much more comfortable working in this straight up position. So that's really a good thing. For covering a larger area, you know, you just back away and you get a wider spray like that. Close up, you get a line. You know, so if I made a dot that size right there and I pulled this back without moving my finger anymore, that dot would look fuzzy. In other words, I didn't pull my trigger back any further each, you know, when I did this here, pull it out here. And it just basically has to do with closeness or further away and air on and paint on and off. So the freehand results give you a really, you know, the airbrush is out of focus or without a stencil. So when you spray onto an edge, you get that result. If you lift this shield a little bit higher, you can still get a line, but you get a less sharper line. So there's a lot of ways to go about creating. There's a bit edgy there. Back further, it's very soft, but it's still a line. It's really great. So somewhere in there, but the freehand, once you practice and really start to control the airbrush, you will be able to do all that you need to do as you go, because you'll have control. You'll have total control here. Okay, so let's get back down around here. I'm going to go back in here and second coat this right there. Pretty wide spray. Go over here. Getting in close. If I do go on and start seeing too much mess on here, like it's starting to get foggy, then I can just clean it all up and back and forth. You go back to the darker color and I could reestablish. That's actually too sharp compared to that for me. So I'll go back in and I'll try to get a little more fuzzier edge right there. But in the meantime, it's all going according to plan. I just have to keep working it and getting across the sky here to the less orange area that's waiting. Okay, so I'm gonna go back in here again. Okay. All right. Now I'm going to work a little bit in here just so you can see. I'm not going to do the whole sky in the video. I have to mix the other color. I don't even think I'll make that part, that be part of a video. You can see what I'm doing here. To lay over the second color is the same thing as you bring the darker over the orange that's already here waiting. Say I was going to darken this side. I would just come in and sweep out and away. Okay, so that it melts, and that's the beauty of the airbrush. You can get that softness. All right, so let's see this area here. I'm just going to work away from it by aiming out, but it's still soft. That's not a line. A line would look cartoonish and start to give me problems. Okay, now this has film, and that's a good thing. And in the reference picture, I just want to bring it over one more time. I'm going to have the tree line cutting up into this area later. Okay, so right now, I'm just going to go for working around here. I don't think this is dark enough, but let's test it. Let's see. All right, so here we go. You don't have to worry now as far as spraying along the edge, because it's protected. I probably have to mix up a darker value. Let's just see. Further away. Get that nice, soft blend. All right, so at this point, it's time just after get this in a little bit more right around the top area. So I am going to spray another coat right there. Pretty heavily sprayed in. All right. So at this point, you can clean up your film. Kind of see the contrast right there. And that looks like it's going to work really, really good. Yeah, there's the true edge right there. And the paint dries really quick, so even getting a little speckle on there, it's not going to, be a problem. All right. So you can see where this is going. I'm going to take this off so you can kind of get a feel for the extreme lighting that's coming through the tarp or the clear area of the canopy. I will be going back in here and I'll be spraying in some brighter, more saturated yellow, just a little brighter in here just to kick it up. And just, I have to go back over the area. Let me see if I can zoom. Well, my camera is in this new position. It's rigged that if I do touch it, it'll really wiggle a lot. So as far as zooming in and stuff, I have to figure out how to go about that, because this thing will bounce all over the place. But anyway, this area, let me get something to point with. Okay. Right here, we got that and this area, I'm reworking. I'm trying to get the right color. It's more orange and I went red. So I might take a correction color and wipe that area out. Correction color is white, again with a little bit of orange in it, to go after the blue shift. So when I spray color back on top of the white paint, it'll make it stay the color I need and not be shifting over to an ugly bluish kind of ruined color. All right. And this area here from the film, you can see it's pretty clear to begin with, but it's looking more like that. So now, as you can imagine, the rest of the sky being laid in, and then the darker over here, I could let the whole sky just be this value, this color, but there's something about that darker nighttime look that will bring it, you know, bring it around. Also, I noticed there was some, it was just a little bit orangey red down in here, and I kind of oversaturated this area. So I'm going to use the correction color. I put too much red. I used the red right out of the bottle and started to tint. You stay on that trigger a couple seconds too long and you get too much paint. So you really have to go very slow and add paint very carefully, maybe one, two passes, look at it, because I was just tinting it and it was already a nice orange. That one still is. This is now too fiery red. I could leave it because, you know, nobody would know if they didn't see this picture. The sunset does get intense at the bottom of the sky. That's a natural look, but I want the orange back in there, so I will do the correction color. That's the nice thing. The correction color is your eraser. Without it, you have to really be careful. You know, maybe sand down the board or get the erasers out, but a correction color actually works back over, like I was saying earlier. It takes care of the color shift and allows you to do your thing. So let's bring some of the orange just into this area, okay? So I've got, and again, I don't mind putting, probably, let's see, in the picture, somewhere around here, the tree line starts going up in this area. So I don't mind having the orange down in here because the dark sepia brown or whatever it is there is gonna go right over the top of that. So you just spray, and the nice thing with the film is you just spray right onto it. Everything can stay even looking. You have a wide spray. My finger is going back and forth. Okay, I'll try to do it this way so you can see it. Okay, watch my finger instead of the spray. Air's on. You see the pumping back and forth? That is how you do it. Darker, and it's very uniform, very even, and it's looking more and more like the picture. Now, I will finish this off camera as far as mixing the other brown or orange. I am going to probably add some black down here. I did mix this, and it's just too much like a deep sepia, and I want to take, but I like the fact that it's down waiting for the black and not the pure white board. So when I start spraying my black, I'm going to pull away as I come up. I'm not going to let the black go all the way up. I want the seagull in this area to still have some brown in it, but the bottom, I want it to be like real intense, like the photograph. You can see, and maybe the seagull is, let's look at it. Yeah, it's pretty dark. So I will bring the black up onto him, but a little bit lighter. I still want to see a little color in that. But down here, it's going to get darker. All those adjustments are going to make this look like it's plugged in. It's just going to help. The darker it is down here, it's already starting to happen. This is making this pop. The white of the board before, when you saw it earlier in the video, it's like something you just have to trust when I did the sunset painting with the evergreen tree, and I was bringing the sunset in, and it was just a drawing of a whiteboard with a drawing of evergreen branches. And the intensity of the night scene didn't happen until I brought those dark blackish branches into the picture. And then the sunset popped out, like really, you know, it's just exciting to watch as you paint. It's really fun. I love landscapes, I think, more than anything. Before I painted with the airbrush, back when I was a little kid, actually, I would draw lots of things that were very mechanical drawing, freehand. I could really understand perspective easier than, say, drawing a face or something. I didn't even go there. I just wasn't interested in that. But I did a lot of landscapes with oils, and eventually, you know, I came about finding out about the airbrush, and then it just won me over. I fell in love with it. It's an incredible tool. Having said that, I want to mention safety for your breathing. Okay. A mask. Again, my fans aren't on right now because the video will be all noisy and you won't be able to hear me as clear. But a paper mask, at least, window open, a fan blowing the paint away from you. I've developed a tickle in my throat from like the t-shirt paint. Because remember, even with my ventilation desk at my studio, the t-shirt and the board are right in front of you. The paint's going to blow in and blow back. And being that I'm a teacher and I'm telling the students and I'm demonstrating and I'm doing all that, and I'm going to swallow more paint because I'm talking, and it's just it's hard to teach with the mask on. But t-shirts really